In the management of postpartum hemorrhage, if you've gone through your medication algorithm and you're still facing a woman who is hemorrhaging and showing signs of hemodynamic instability, you need to consider placing a uterine tamponade device, such as a Bakri balloon. The kit contains a Bakri balloon, tubing connected to a one-way valve, a stopcock, a 50 milliliter syringe, and you will need to gather a basin with some sterile saline or sterile water, or an IV bag that has at least 500 milliliters of saline or sterile water. The first step is to place the Bakri balloon. To do this, you can use a set of ring forceps to help guide the balloon into the uterine cavity. You do not want to use any forceps that may have a pointed tip, as this could perforate the uterine wall. You can also place this just using your hands. That's what we'll do here. I'm going to gently insert through the vagina, through the cervix, and into the uterine cavity. When I feel like that's in place, if I have an ultrasound available, I can actually take a quick look and just to verify the correct placement. At that point, I'm going to hold the Bakri balloon in place with my hand. I'm going to request some assistance. And I'm going to instruct my assistant to please attach the stopcock to the end of my device. There are two ways to fill a Bakri balloon. This is the manual way. I'm going to have my assistant now draw up 50 milliliters of sterile saline or sterile water. It's important not to use air during this, as if it were to rupture, you could cause an air embolism. As my assistant is instilling the saline, I'm making sure that the Bakri balloon is still seated properly in the uterine cavity. I also am trying to keep track of how many milliliters I'm actually inserting into the Bakri balloon. The minimum we want to place is 350 mLs. After each inflation, make sure that you turn the stopcock, as if you do not, the liquid will drain out. After we get up to 350 mLs, we're going to actually check for bleeding. The faster way to actually instill fluid into your Bakri balloon, take the accompanying tubing and spike an IV bag. If I don't have an IV bag available, I can actually use that tip and just place it in the basin of water. This here is a one-way valve. And then using the same 50 ml syringe, we're going to connect immediately to the device. All right, go ahead and draw back, and that should automatically draw up your fluid. Because this is a one-way valve, as soon as she is done drawing up, she can go ahead and instill without actually separating the syringe. And you can see now the fluid is going directly into the Bakri balloon. We're gonna continue doing this until we have a total of 350 mLs in the balloon. It's really important that someone is keeping track because it's very easy to lose track of how many times you've actually done this. Once you've instilled 350 milliliters of fluid into the Bakri balloon, you're gonna need to check for ongoing hemorrhage. To do that, I'm actually going to connect a Foley catheter bag to the port here on the part of the Bakri balloon. I'm going to look for ongoing hemorrhage, and with that Foley bag, I can actually calculate how much blood loss I've had. If there is ongoing hemorrhage, I'm going to continue to put more fluid into the Bakri balloon up to a total of 500 milliliters of fluid. At that point, I need to stop. I'm going to keep my Foley bag connected so we can measure that blood loss, and I'm going to keep the Bakri balloon in place until an obstetrician tells me to remove it. The final step is to place a Foley catheter into the bladder because there's a high chance that by placing this Bakri balloon, the patient is now going to have urinary retention and you'll need to relieve that with the Foley.